market itself. You need to know who's going to be interested in buying products from you. This is a real serious problem at the moment with a lot of recyclers because, first of all, the cost of virgin material varies a lot, which means that the cost of recycling, which is fairly fixed, tends to be either on a positive side or a negative side of that equation. And the second thing is information. Do you know what the material is going to behave like? There is hardly any information on the properties of these materials which are being recycled, and people like ourselves try to generate data. Quite often when clients come to us and ask for that information, but of course we also like to do this as a longer term study through research as well, which is what we're trying to do. We also try and see if in fact the old-fashioned rules of how you blend and what you blend can be broken, because you want to save money and cost, money and time. Concerns of reprocessors, quality issues. First of all, as I mentioned, the availability of technology. We need techniques for identifying and separating plastics by type and additives. There are techniques which are in use. Some are very scientific. Some are used in practice on recycling lines. They work to a certain extent. There are systems which are becoming cheaper as more and more technology becomes on the market and more users come on the market as well. Separation materials. We have labels, we have coatings, laminates. All of those add to the problems of recycling. What do we do? Where do we stop? Separation of elastomers from plastics with similar densities. We have a company, especially recycling, who have a sorting facility which is based on using tents, flotation tents. Now, they have a problem with a lot of it creates a material which overlap because of the additives that are used. Densities aren't fixed, and that's a key issue for them. Separation method foil from plastics. Copper wrappers are great, but they're difficult to recycle. Tetra Pak is great, but again, difficult to recycle. Separation method inserts for the products. Material variability. Now, one of the great problems, and a lot of people who are making products for high standards, and we've been trying to look at recycled materials in their products, have always complained about the reliability of their source of material, even their own material, which has gone to a customer, tends to be variable because of the nature of the use that the material we put to. Due to additives and component types. And this is particularly important, of course, with high-value products. Contamination and damage. In the process of use of the product, you will get damage. There's presence of foreign material which is collected. You can just dust and sand it at one end. Or from the shredders, you'll get metal particles which are in your product, which have to be taken out. Environmental damage from previous UV exposure and oxidation. We've done a study of this, a long-term study, looking at this aspect. Damage, as I said, from granulated and processing equipment. Hazardous materials, the laws have changed on what you can put back into the system. The materials that were used 15 years ago, which are now turning up, will have an additive which are now bad. So you've got to look at that aspect as well. Thermal degradation during processing, again, reprocessing will cause further damage. Other factors. You need to select the materials very carefully. You have to look at the markets for recyclers, which are not consistent, not constant. You have to look at the cost differential, as I mentioned, between recycling and virgin material. You've got to look at volumes. If you find a market and the buyer wants 100 tons a year, and you can only supply 10 tons, or it's variable within 210, that's not going to be very good for them. The collection infrastructure has to be sound. It's going to be part of the same process. The property modification has to be understood and has to be taken care of. So you may need to blend or whatever is necessary to bring the material back up to the specification required. There's been various studies. This is a study done in the USA on waste from electrical electronic equipment. They looked at several products, televisions, packaging, communication electronics, and so on. And in this particular study of 700 tons of material, the majority were TVs, you see here. I won't go into the details, given the time. When it's broken down, you find this kind of product. You've got seals, thermal packaging, cathode ray tubes, glass lead, solid waste, printed circuit boards, and so on, and plastics. It's interesting. existing plastic will be discarded as plastics in a separate year. Of the total of 700 tons, only 30 tons was plastic, which was only about 4.5% of the total, which is another problem for the polymer industry, because the amounts that you get out of an operation are not that significant in some cases like this. And these are the resins that were found in that example. High impact polystyrene, because TVs used to have that material for casing, has changed. ABS, which is the standard for computer monitors and so on, and now of course TVs too. 17% of end-of-life electronics is now plastic, which is quite significant, and the Association of Polymer Manufacturers in Europe identified 12 types in this particular example. We'll just go on from that. One of the key points about this, with the presence of polymers, is the additives that are used in polymers. And just to mention some of them, presence of lead, cadmium, and mercury in plastic residue is something that has to be dealt with, has to be extracted, removed. Because if they are polymers, they're not burned, but I think generally speaking, recycling, that has to be taken out, taken account of. Flame retardants also a problem. The directive, the European Parliament, relating to this kind of waste, actually bans certain types of materials. And I've just got a few categories. Substances, for example, the PCBs, polychlorinated polyphenols, the capacitors containing those materials have to be taken out. Toner cartridges, liquid and paste, and color toners have to be removed. CFC, HCFC, HFC and hydrocarbon materials, external electrical cables have to be taken out, plastics containing chlorinated flame retardants have to be taken out. So, we look at, so there are the problems, and we go on to look at solutions. Now, there are solutions of different types. First of all, looking at high volume solutions. This is one example of a company called Mathew, which produces products now. Here's an example of the way the material is sold. This company makes a polymer from polyethylenes and polypropylenes. Most of the consumer waste, 30%. Most of the waste comes from supermarket stores. There's another 70% of material there, which is production waste. And this is converted into artificial wood products. And they're made by PTI recycled wood products. Looking at medium value engineering solutions, containers from HDPE models. There's no problem in converting containers, HDPE containers back into them. We proved it, we made them, but the industry are not very happy always to use them. One successful area has been in the use of the automotive industry for containers for antifreeze and engine oil and that kind of thing. But they will not be, automotive industry will not use them for windscreen wash pipe bottles in the car because of the nervousness with using recycled materials in car components. Road signs and barriers have been used to make from HDPE wood carbons and medium density polyethylene pipes as well. The process involves, as you can see, the materials are washed, granulated, washed, dried, compounded, and molded in test cases. They're tested first of all. We look at the standards for the industry and match them first of all, and once we're happy, components are made when they're tested as well. Construction is simply made, successfully made load-bearing beams. Again, we go through a fairly rigorous process. It's taken 5 years to achieve this. There's a problem with nervousness at the moment of the company at last minute. They want to version